Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. The lead vocalist from the band Voxx. They're a hard rock band based out of Tampa, Florida, playing high energy music with catchy melodies and great guitar riffs. His name is Regis. Thank you for joining me.
Thanks for having me, John. Appreciate the invitation.
Bro, I'm so happy to have you on, and congratulations on winning the Best Alternative Rock Song with Frankenstein in the 2020 Banger Music Awards.
Thank you. That was very, very cool. The whole band was super excited. We're following the voting, you know, asking everybody to get your website, and that was super cool. Super cool.
So why don't you tell everybody a little bit about the band?
All right. So, as you said, we're from Tampa, Florida, Tampa Bay, Florida. We are, as a regional band, we're a new band. And we used to be a cover band years and years ago for almost, I would say, 8 years. I decided to step out. You know, I stepped out to write original music. The band continued with a different name, of course, with a different singer. They kept playing as a cover band. But it didn't work out well, so they shut down that band. And in the meantime, I was looking for musicians to play with me. I was gonna do a solo project, but we ended up meeting up. You know, by chance we talked, and you know, the rest is history. We just got together and we're just playing together. You know, it's like meeting an old friend. You know, we have great chemistry on stage. We learn music together. You know, it's just like riding a bicycle. You never forget. You know what I mean? So things are good, man. Really good.
Now, is there a story behind the name Voxx?
Yes. My solo project was supposed to be Regis Voxx, V-O-X, with one X. Voxx means voice, vocals, you know, singing, that kind of stuff in Latin. So since I turned into a band, I was talking to the guys, and one of them, Carl, the bass player, suggests, he's like, why don't we keep Voxx, but with the just add another X at the end? I was like, sold. You know what I mean? That's much easier. So that's the story about the name of it.
So yeah. When did you guys start doing originals?
Originals, when I stepped out was 2017, 2018. And then throughout that period, 2018, 2019, for a whole year, I wrote the original songs, and we became a band last May. So we're not even a year together yet as a regional band.
So that would have been right around the time Frankenstein came out.
Yes, exactly. That was fresh.
Why don't you tell everybody about the band influences that you have?
Well, mainly, of course, I'm a huge fan, not because he passed away, and I tell everybody, of Chester Bennington, Linkin Park. You know, I've been listening to them since the end of, you know, 1999. And it was a big influence for me, you know. But the band has other influences, as Tool, Breaking Benjamin, and Chevelle. You know, we have Rage Against the Machine and so on. Hard rock, you know, not metal, but hard rock music. You know, we like melodic hard rock, you know what I mean, like modern, nothing, you know, old school. So that's pretty much everybody's influences, you know.
And you have a new single coming out, am I right about that?
Yes, the video came out on Valentine's Day. It's called Ballerina, and it's a ballad, you know what I mean? It's not a very slow song, but it's a very catchy, you know, again, melodic. And it's going to be on the digital platforms on Friday, this coming up Friday, February 28th, I'm sorry. And it'll be available for everybody, but it's on YouTube already.
What's that song about?
Well, when I started writing about that song, it's funny, I wrote down with my friend Larry LaFauce. We were writing the lyrics, and he had a little guitar riff, a track that was just an acoustic one. And he's like, I have this track here, see if you like it, Regis. So I start listening, and I closed my eyes, and I said to him, and I said, I just see, like, this song like a ballerina dancing on stage with the spotlight on her. And he's like, that's a good title. So from that point on, the meaning of the lyrics, if that's what you would like to know, is I had this subject. One of my friends said to me, Regis, you have the personality that you're like a fixer. You always try to help everybody. So pretty much the lyrics that says that the ballerina falls and you go there and pick her up and she falls again and you pick her up. That's pretty much my personality, to help everybody. Until the point that, you know, you learn and you let the person go. You know what I'm saying? So pretty much the meaning of the lyrics when we wrote, that's what it's all about.
The song Frankenstein. Give us a little background on that song.
That pretty much is like everybody goes through the same in life. You know, you fall apart, you know, in pieces, you know, and you put the pieces together, you get up and keep going. Similar to Frankenstein, you know, that he's put together in pieces and eventually, you know, he comes up and start walking. So that's the meaning behind the whole story. It's pretty interesting, you know, because a lot of people have different understanding about the lyrics, but that's the meaning behind it. It's more like, you know, the pieces fall apart, you get up and put the pieces together and keep on going. You know what I mean? It's more motivational than anything else.
And you learn that from that martial arts you're into.
Yes, absolutely. it has helped me so much. It's incredible.
Do you, what do you do? Taekwondo?
I do Taekwondo and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I do both.
Yeah, I'm a black belt in Taekwondo. So.
Nice. Yes, sir.
So, I was reading that you guys just got an endorsement. Who's that with?
Yes, that's our second one. Yeah, we got the first one through Maverick, which is a brand here in Orlando, Florida. And they're doing great things. They're expanding to label management, not just clothing. And then we got another one that I just announced today. We just received the email yesterday from Dirtbag Clothing. They're in the business since 96. I mean, they have bands under their roster like Hailstorm and Bumblefoot, or who else is there? Blackstone Cherry. There's so many names. So, you know, and little by little we're getting, you know, more endorsements and being more visible, you know.
Now, is that because the songs that are in the past? Is that because you're going out and showing them how good you are? You guys playing a lot? Because I see you got some really good upcoming shows.
Yes. We have, I would say for the next 6 months, we have about one show average a month. This coming up week in March, we're going to participate in Florida, in Tampa, Florida. It's called the Battle of the Bands. They did it like a online voting, and the top 10 bands will perform there March 4th, and then out of the 10 bands, two bands, they will push to the finals, which will be March 7th, and the winner band will make $10,000.
Oh man, that sounds great.
Yeah, we're busting ass, man, to get there. So
now, is that a live gig you got to play, or is that just votes online?
Oh no, just live. We'll be judging. There'll be people there voting. It's a festival, so there'll be a bunch of stages. We're gonna play for the preliminary in a small stage, and then the finals will be in a big stage. So the finals will be just two bands. First gets 10. Second place gets 5.
Do you have the songs picked? Is it one song? Do you have to play a small set? What's the deal there?
No, they give you a time frame. They give you about an hour.
Oh.
And then you have to take off like the time that you have to set up, time to take down. So we're probably going to play about 35, 40 minutes. But we are allowed to play originals and covers. Some of the bands, they will play just covers. But there's some killer bands there too, man. They'll be great.
You're going to squeeze in Frankenstein?
Oh yeah, all the originals will be out. Will be five originals.
And then you're also gigging with Saliva, am I correct?
Yes, we were supposed to last week, and they rescheduled for April 23rd. They had some with one of the family members, the band member's family. Somebody had a surgery or something, so they couldn't play here in Tampa. So we'll be in April.
That's got to be exciting because they're a pretty big band.
Yes, man. And you know, we were definitely excited for that.
So as we're winding things down, why don't you give people a little bit of information as far as your social media is, where they can contact you, where they can buy your material, and so on.
Okay, so social media-wise, we are on Facebook. You can find us as Voxx, V-O-X-X. We are on Instagram. We are on Spotify. We are changing to a management that everything is going to be on Spotify starting this Friday, including Ballerina, Apple Music, Google Play, and so on. We're on Twitter and Reverbnation. It's very easy to find us. I'm very good with, you know, all of us to replying emails, messages. You see when you send me a message, you know, I'm always on my phone replying. We're pretty good about that. So that's pretty much where we are. We're pretty much everywhere where every band should be, you know, on social media. But that's the way it is nowadays, man, you know. You can see our videos on YouTube. We have four videos there, four songs. And probably in the next 3 months, we have one more single coming out. That one would be a cool one, too.
And the songs you're talking about are Frankenstein, Ballerina, Close My Eyes,
and Two Sides.
Right, we played that on the show as well.
Yes, you guys being awesome to us, man. So thankful.
Well, we love you, and I have to say, Doris and many of the other listeners that tune in are really big fans of you. Regis from the band Voxx. Check them out on Facebook, YouTube, and all over the place.
Thanks so much, John. Appreciate it.